Is it ever going to be my turn? Is anybody home? Hey, hey. Welcome to a fantastically magical day where I am feeling something special in the air, and it's definitely not sunshine. We're having kind of a gray day here, but I would just like to start your day off with some old school music that you've not heard in a while. Well, you might have seen it on my feed in a while, because for my birthday, Christopher did get me a $30 gift card to iTunes, which is great because he said he was tired of me playing the same song and I needed new music. And that's just me about to choke my car down while I talk. But let's start out with some music, shall we? And I want to ask you something. How are you planning for this day? Are you planning for success? Did you get up before the world got up? Get up to plan your day before the dinglings take over, you know what I mean? Which is a great way for all the notifications, the pings, the dings, and the dinglings, right? Sums it up. So anyway, did you do that? Did you plan your day? Are you waiting on your day to be planned for you? Because that's what's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? Are you picking up what I'm laying down? Let's have some music, and I'm going to park up here, and I want to tell you something I was thinking about. And I was talking to my new friend Allison yesterday, and this one was on point. And she had, I'll tell you why, because she had a really strong why she was going to do different, to get different. And I, you know, typically, I know this about myself. I believe in people more than they believe in themselves. But this lady, she believed it too. And I was on board with her energy, and I'm excited. She didn't realize this, but I'm going to be watching her on Instagram. I'm going to be following up with her. Anyway, let's have some music. And you know what? Let me see. Go? Did it go? What? Hold on. See, this is a problem. Hold on. I don't understand why the music has stopped. Why is it so gray today? And where is the sunshine? But anyway, I wanted to tell you something I was talking to her about, but I'm going to wait till I get up here. And I see the sun, I really do. Here comes the sun, I say. Imagine yourself listening to this while you're having a big green drink. Hi! Hang on. So let me tell you what I was talking to her about. Think of these two scenarios, okay? There's the sun. Hello, beautiful. Do you think about this? Do you ever hear anybody say, yeah, I believe it when I see it. I believe that when I see it. How about switching it around? I'll see it when I believe it. Listen to the difference in that. I believe it when I see it. I'll see it when I believe it. Are you going to wait until you feel like doing it? Are you going to wait till you feel motivated? Are you going to do the new thing, the new action, the new eating, the new health, the new blank? Are you going to do it so you feel motivated? Are you going to wait till you feel like doing it? Are you going to do it so you feel like it? That's the key right there. Right there is the essence and the key to your success or failure. Motivation is a load of crap. You are not going to get up every day of your life and feel motivated to do blank. You're just not. However, do the thing. Start gaining momentum. You know, a lot of times people become overwhelmed. They're like, I don't know where to start. Or, well, I'm going to eat raw food the rest of my life. No, you're going to eat raw food. Or let's not even, I don't like to put it in that box, because some people, that's not their goals and dreams. Oh, look at the land movers. love to see dump trucks and stuff, don't y'all? I don't know what that is. It's like Bob the Builder used to be my favorite show when Christopher was a kid, and he outgrew that, and I was so sad. Bob the Builder, can we fix it? Yes, we can. Bob was positive, you know, and so was Lofty. Anyway, so what I'm saying is, it feels overwhelming. Like, we don't understand how to get from where we are to where we want to be, right? We don't understand. Here's what you do. You break it down into moments. I know y'all are happy we're going to Walmart. I can't believe the sun's coming out because it was supposed to be cloudy today. But anyway, let's see if we can have a fantastic place to park, shall we? I don't want to be too bright, but like, let's see. So, listen. I was talking to this lady yesterday. That's too bright. And I was saying, you know, what's it going to look like? Where is it? What's your goal? Where is it you want to be? You know, when you think about yourself, she had some weight loss and that she needed to have happen. Why did she need that? For vanity purposes? No, because it's creating dis-ease in her body. She had two little kids. Like, nobody's going to be mommy but her. Nobody's going to show up. And guess what? Nobody's going to show up to parent her but her. And she had realized that. And she was ready to show up in her life, and it was exciting. I text my daughter after that. I was like, I believe that was one of the greatest calls I've ever had. This lady meant business. It is the love in my life to talk to people with passion and drive. You know what I mean? Anyway, so I was saying, you know, when you picture yourself where you want to be, what's that look like? What's your goal weight? What will be your goal? The way you want to feel, the way you want to move, the way you want to show up in your life, you know? And she started explaining that, and she started getting excited about it. I said, well, you know what? See, she had asked me, well, this plan we're going over, what about like when I reach my goals and all, what's going to be different? When I said, well, you know what's interesting? Look at the way I eat. Do you know the very things I do now to hold on to my results are the very things that got me the results? Now, what do you think if I went back to eating a sad or standard diet? Guess what? I would have standard results. I would have the results I had before. Dis-ease on my body, fat on my body, mental disturbances, gut disorders. I have no doubt about it. What do you think would happen to me if I went and ate McDonald's for three meals a day, every day for a month? Do you think I would be the same me? No. I would be the old me. And I didn't love her. And I love me now. So I wouldn't do that to myself. Because as a parent of myself, I love myself like that. You know what I mean? And nobody's coming to do that for her. Nobody's going to. That's the thing. You've got to see the results in your little mind's eye before you get there. Are you going to believe it when you see it? Are you going to see it so you believe it? See it in your mind. Get up like you're that person you're going to become. Because guess what? You are her. You're in there. You're still in there. Do you know? Or have you forgotten and lost sight of who you were before this world stole your beauty and told you who you were going to be? Let's get her back out of the box. Right? Let's get him back out of the box. Let's rekindle your childlike dream when you can move and dance and breathe, and you woke up like every day was Christmas morning because you were excited. A lot of times I ask people, what are you excited about in your life? And guess what? They don't know. But oh, I do. I have hopes and dreams that every day I almost wake up before my alarm clock at 4 o'clock because I'm excited to manifest my life. You want to half hiney do this thing? Well, you're going to get half hiney results. you want to have 100% results, guess what? You have to put in 100% effort. You will never get 100% results by putting in 40% effort. It just doesn't work that way. You got to get up when other people are sleeping. You got to step up when other people are slacking. Right? You got to have a plan when nobody else can even is thinking about that. All they're thinking about is going on Facebook and typing in what their favorite color was as a kid, or what was, I don't know, an image from your childhood that will give away your age. You know what that is, my friend? It's a distraction from your life. And while you're typing and while you're doing all these things, it takes you, they say, 18 minutes to get back to your task-oriented situation because you went on Facebook and you allowed yourself. That's just an example. The ding-a-lings. Why are you allowing ding-a-lings to control your destiny? Why? Why are you waiting to feel like it to do it? Why don't you do it so you feel like it? Right? Well, how is it you're talking to yourself? Do you realize that what you put after the words, I am, are so powerful? On the other night, I was coming home from, I love the sunshine in my eyes. I feel like it's energy coming inside. And the other day, I was coming home from a little date I had with a new friend. And there was a wreck on 85. I couldn't tell what happened, but it was backed up for miles. And what should have taken me 30 minutes to get home took me an hour and 50 minutes. And as I sat there, this car is a stick shift, you know, riding the clutch. All I could really do was have gratitude that I am sitting in this traffic jam and I'm looking at the harvest moon. And it was looking at me and I was photoing and I was just looking at how big and bright. And but I could have said, I'm so unlucky to get in this traffic jam. I am broke. I am tired. I'm alone. I'm single. I'm fat. I am fat. I am disgusting. I'm lonely. I am lost. No. I am powerful. I am creating my dreams. I am beautiful. I am unique. I am authentic.